Gloria for a very long time. I was speaking to her on the phone and I was saying, Mama, I know you very well, but you may not meet, you may not know me, but I know you very well. You know, when you are, sometimes when you are back home, you want to hide, you know, sitting at the benches, and you'll be seeing the elders of the church. What in the church? I want to thank God for her today, because she's here with us, Liverpool. Amen. A prayer warrior, a woman of God, ready to do the work of God at any time as the Lord desires. I want to greet you, Mama. I want to welcome you at Liverpool Assembly. We want to welcome you. We want to love you. We want to welcome you. We love you, Mama. And we want to lift this day to you.
This year, 2014, Baba says it's a year of seeking revelation of knowing our inheritance in God and Christ and have faith of having it. Amen. Amen. Revelation of knowing our inheritance in God and have faith of having it. Amen. Let's open to Hebrews chapter 6, verse 12. Hallelujah. Hebrews 6, verse 12. If you are there, you can read.
Hebrews 6, verse 12. We do not want you to become lazy, but imitate those who through faith and patience inherit what has been promised.
Hallelujah. In our letter here, Baba is saying, is just quoting Hebrews chapter 6, verse 12b, who through faith and patience inherit the promises. Amen.
Amen.
Who through faith and patience inherit the promises. My sermon today will be mostly based on a testimony.
Amen.
It will be testimonial preaching.
Amen.
I will take from the inheritance, but you will hear mostly from my testimony. Amen.
Amen.
I know it will help one or two. Hallelujah.
Amen.
When we came to the Lord, it was in 1990. The God of this church is a very good God.
Amen.
I say that because I once was worshiping in another church. We had another church where we were going, but there was nothing that was moving on our life. There was nothing much we could say. In fact, it was moving, yes. But then I would say I was enjoying the greatness of God or the goodness of God.
Amen.
Because we would say when we, after finishing church in that other church, we would go to prophets and mangas to solve our problems. Because the other God couldn't do it.
Amen.
But when we came to forward in faith, things just started to brighten up. Spiritually, amen.
Amen.
But physically, we had everything. We had a nice house, we had some cars, we had lorries, tractors, and a farm, and we were growing tobacco. And you know, in the world, they say, oh, these people are rich. But we had a debt. Amen.
Amen.
This farm, we had acquired it. Not the Jambanja, but the Zukutenga. We had bought it, but then we had bought it with funds from the bank. And then we needed to repay the money.
Amen.
So when we came to the Lord, we didn't, we were growing tobacco. But as time went on, after about 2 to 3 years, we started, the Holy Spirit started convicting us. And we went to the man of God and asked him if we could continue growing tobacco. And then he said, oh yes, Lana, you can still grow tobacco because tobacco is not only used for smoking. It's used for many things, for perfumes, for other insecticides and the like. So it's not a sin to grow tobacco. But then myself and my husband and myself said, ah no, we should stop growing it. The Holy Spirit had told us not to grow it. So we stopped growing it. But since we had borrowed money from the bank, we couldn't now repay the money to the bank used growing maize and other crops. And we had a problem there. The debt kept on increasing, but we couldn't pay it off. Of course, in this church, our father, when he went to America, he was told, you should teach people to give, you should teach people my ways, you should teach people working talents, you should teach people giving tithes. All those we did. And they say, if you come into this church with one pair of shoes or one coat, you will not remain the same. After 2 or 3 years, there should be a change upon your life. But in our case, as we work the talents, whenever there was a time to work talents, people would come and testify. Oh, after working talents, I bought a stand. After working talents, I now have a car. After working talents, I now have a house. But on our part, it was vice versa. Whenever we worked the talents, things would be dropping down and down. Things will be going down and down. We had nothing to just say, after working talents, God did this and this. There was not much of us to show off. But God is faithful.
Amen.
The word of God in Galatians chapter 6, verse 7, it says, do not be deceived. God is not mocked.
Amen.
For whatever you are going to sow, you shall reap.
Yes.
If you do not lose heart.
Amen.
Because along the way, there are things which make you lose heart.
Amen.
There are things which make you grow weary in well-doing.
Amen.
Imagine working talents, some are testifying that God has done this and this, and you are just sitting there, you have got nothing tangible to tell them that God did this and this. You will grow weary and you will lose heart. But God's word is very faithful.
Amen.
He is faithful to do what he says in his word.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And Galatians chapter 6 verse 9 says, and let us not grow weary while doing good, for in due season we shall reap if we do not lose heart. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So as I told you, things started getting down, and our relatives would come and laugh at us and say, now you see this church in which you have joined. We told you that they love a lot of money, and now your money is gone, and now you are looking miserable. And even some people in the church, some would be sent by the devil just to discourage you. And they will come and say, do you think you repented fully? Maybe there are some things you didn't quite repent of. What is happening? Because we know in this church, when you come to this church, you should be testifying about the goodness of the Lord. Until we reached a time that all the cars were just broken down. The lorry we used to ferry people to big centers, it was broken down. The cars were broken down. But we continued giving God.
Amen.
It was not easy, people of God.
Amen.
To give when things are going down, it needs the grace of God.
Amen.
I am encouraged by this scripture in the year of inheritance, Hebrews 6, verse 12b, which says, who through faith and patience inherit the promises.
Amen.
Amen.
We need to have faith and patience.
Amen.
At times it's very hard to be patient enough, because we see in the Bible the prodigal son, he was not patient enough to wait for the inheritance. And he said, because he was immature, he said, give me my inheritance.
Amen.
Give me right now, Father. Give me my inheritance, because I want to spend it. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And he was given. We all know the story that he went to a faraway country and he squandered all the inheritance to a point that he was now feeding with the swine until he realized his mistakes and came back to the Father. Instead of saying, give me, he came back saying, make me. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So at times when we are going through things, there is a time we should realize and say, Father, make me into the vessel you want me to be.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Because on our own, we cannot do anything.
Amen.
We came with nothing in the world and we are going to go with nothing. Everything belongs unto God.
Amen.
The silver and the gold belongs unto God.
Amen.
The world and its fullness belongs unto God.
Hallelujah.
Even ourselves, we belong unto Him.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Amen. We are the potter of His hands and we are the clay. He has got the clay in His hands as the potter, and He makes us into the vessels which He wants us to be. Hallelujah. As we will be going through fire like that, God is taking away some things from us.
Amen.
Maybe it is the pride of life.
Amen.
Maybe it is that bitterness.
Amen.
Maybe it is that unforgiving spirit.
Amen.
God is taking away the dross as He puts more fire on our lives and takes away everything.
Amen.
Until we say we are just like Him. We reflect Him. As the refiner sits on the pot of silver or gold which is being refined, they say when the refiner finally sees his face reflecting in the pot of the gold, that's when he knows that the silver is done.
Amen.
That's when he knows that the gold is done. So that's what God at times does into our lives.
Amen.
He stops it. Putting all those things, those pressures around us until He sees His image on us.
Amen.
He sees His image reflecting on us.
Amen.
God is so very good and faithful.
Amen.
He loves us as His children.
Amen.
And He likes us to be like Him.
Amen.
To be more of Him every day.
Amen.
So He might put us in pressure and through the fire. The Bible says, though we walk through waters and the fires,
Amen.
He will see us through. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And we will not be scorched by the fire.
Amen.
And the water will not drown us.
Amen.
He will just be there to guide us.
Amen.
Because He loves us as His children.
Amen,
amen and amen.
Amen.
Now, as we were going through this predicament, it was very painful, people of God. Imagine when you have everything. And then things start deteriorating. There was a time I remember I was a teacher. I did many professions, but when I was a teacher, that's when these things happened. So we would not have money to send our children to school. Or on Sunday they would have seen us giving in church. The little we had, since we were leaders, you know, as a leader, you are supposed to lead by example.
Amen.
And we would give the little we have, and then at home, there would be nothing. No soap to wash our clothes, not even a times sugar to make tea. And then at times we would have our children not having money to go to school because we were living at the farm. And it was about 10 days to school. They went in school in town. So we would need to say about $1 for them to go to school. But we didn't have that money. Imagine not finding $1 or £1. Maybe you have not gone to such a position, but it happens. It happens to some of us. Hallelujah.
Amen, amen.
But do not be weary of well doing, for in due season you are going to reap.
Amen.
So we would just say, okay, Fuana, you know we don't have money today, but I am a teacher. I have 40 children there where I should go and teach. This money I am going to school to work, and then today don't go to school. I was laughing by myself there when Mama was saying, at times you say children don't go to school and they want to go to school. But I have to thank God because our children understood us. I think it was God who made them to understand us. They would say, okay, Mama, then they would just stay at home. But when they go to school, they all tell the teachers that yesterday we didn't have money to come to school. They will try to give other reasons to cover us up. It was God's doing. Amen.
Amen.
They would complain either that, but yesterday at church you were giving the Lord so much and you were giving all the money until we don't have anything here. They wouldn't do that. God is very faithful. Amen.
Amen.
So we continued in that way and giving God. People would come to our house because they just wanted to come to us.
Amen.
They would come to fellowship with us. They would come to do some prayer beds in the mountains since we lived at a farm. And then at times we would have many visitors in such a way that the blankets were not enough. But we would take our coats for prayer bed and give them, taking those coats for prayer bed for us to have blankets. And then the blankets, actual blankets, we would give to the visitors. Just to accommodate them as if nothing has happened, as if nothing is wrong. But God is very faithful. Do not be weary in well-doing, for in due season you shall reap, if you do not lose that. Because there are many things which on the way will make you weary and make you lose that. We never stopped giving God. And when they said, we are going to work challenge, who would be the first? I remember I would be not beyond number 5. I would be either number 1, number 2, number 3, or number 4. But not somewhere down there. Giving God, with waiting for God with all our strength, with all our might, we were giving God. And as we were giving God, as I told you, things were deteriorating. And the debt was going up. Then we decided with my husband that we should subdivide the farm so that we sell it. And then we can buy a smaller plot and then a house in town because it's quite a big farm. Now the papers didn't go through just like that. It took more than 7 years for them to go through. So as we were in the process of subdividing the farm, the debt at the bank was going up, and they decided to auction the farm. And we were in the papers. People would talk. Look at them. They give to their God. They give a lot of money. And yet things are going down. And this is happening. And at one time, there was one white man who bought the farm at an auction, at a very, very cheap price. And I remember him coming and saying, yeah, now I know that I've bought your farm, but as far as I understand, you've got nowhere to go. You don't even have a house in town or anywhere else where you can go with your family. You look at that mountain there, I'll just give you a portion of land as you sort out your things so that you can stay there for the moment. As I take this farm, because I'm now the new owner and I'm going to grow some wheat because I've got many bakeries in Nagamura and in town, those who know Zimbabwe and Butare. And so that's it. But then we said, no ways. We know the God whom we are.
Amen.
We told people of God and we prayed. God is so faithful. After about 1 week, we saw him coming back again and said, I've decided I no longer want to buy the farm. The money I'm going to take from the people who had taken my money at the auction there, because I'm no longer interested in your farm. Then he said, praise the Lord. Because
Amen.
People of God will pray.
Amen.
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 And another time, they said, right, another company said, we are now going to buy your farm. So you make ready for us so that we can move in next month. We are going to move the papers and all the payments. By next month, we will have paid you. And then you can move out. So we praise the Lord. But at times when the devil wants you to go into something, he makes the transactions which are not genuine. Amen. And I think it was God's way anyway, so that we will have a testimony. Because they say out of great tribulations, there are great testimonies. Hallelujah. So when they said they were going to buy the farm, we started saying the last cattle we had, we said now we can just sell them because we are going to buy a smaller plot which will not accommodate cattle, and we are also going to buy a house in town. So we just sold the cattle and the chickens, we were left with a few, and we are making our way ready to move out. But then after a week of the transaction to go through, they said, we have changed our mind. We are no longer buying the farm. Then we said, but how can they do this to these people? How can they do that? Because we had already sold everything and we were about to move out. But then they said, okay, we are going to give you $50,000. That day, that time, it was a big lot of money, but it wouldn't pay our debt. So we were happy for some time, took the money and covered one or two things, and then we started again, back to square one. We are not enjoying anything much. What shall we do? But we continued giving the Lord. Would give people of God, whenever they come to our house, would cook for them, would give them whatever we had. I remember back home there, we were one of the last people to buy a color TV because we didn't have the money. Other people were saying, now we now have color TVs, but we were having a black and white. And I still remember our sofas were old ones in the home. And one of them had a broken leg. And I still remember, instead of taking some wood to fix the broken leg, we had to take an empty oil tin and then just repair the broken leg. At times you just say, how did we do that? How could we do that? Because at least we would have taken the leg to repair the broken leg. But we opted for a metal tin to repair that leg. So that things just look bad or worse. That as you testify the goodness of the Lord, people will see that sure the Lord lifted them from the dungeon up to there. Hallelujah. Now we continued giving the Lord, and my husband by that time had lost his job to make waiters mess again. So it was one salary. And I remember these days, we had no electricity for 6 months. But we could not have water without electricity because our borehole uses electricity to pump water. So it means for those 6 months, we didn't have electricity to cook. We didn't have electricity to pump water, and there was no water. But I thank God, because in the farm there are rivers or which water runs. So we would go to the river to bathe with my children, and also to just go and make our laundry, and drinking water we would get it from the well. We didn't bother anyone. Amen.
Amen.
God is very good. Hallelujah. But we didn't stop giving God. And we were elders in the church. And then it came, I think, when the Baba and Amai were now at Miracle Center, that's when we had been moved to Chitagatil. We were no longer at Miracle Center. So we were given an assembly right down to where we were closer to where our farm is. Because we were having even problems of coming to church. I still remember these days again when there was a lot of rain during that year, and from where we stayed, the farm to the third road is a dusty road. It's about 1.5 km from where we stay to the third road. So because we had no car now, we were now using public transport. Would go there footing. And because there was a lot of rain that year, you'd just say as you were walking in the road, your foot would just go down in the mud. So we would take some plastics, put on our shoes nicely, put some plastic bag, empty plastic bags of sugar, then take a string, tie this one and tie this one. Then we would walk, hallelujah,
amen.
We would walk to where we could get the public transport. And when we get there, we just take off our plastic bags, put them aside, board our public transport. By that time, we were heading another assembly in Wesley Assembly. They know it in Italy.
Yeah.
But it was part of Miracle Center. That was before we were transferred to Chitakatina. Now we were transferred to another assembly, which is in the rural areas. And when we go to this assembly, to this church, it was not an assembly, it was a church. We saw that there was barely nothing. They used the grass to fetch the church, and the floors were of cow dung. Imagine coming from a church where you had helped to build, because Miracle Center is a very big district and it's very nice. We had helped to build the church, to furnish it, to everything, whatever you can talk of. Even the Jurao, it's our family who did most of it. But then we were transferred to this church with a thatched roof and a cow dung floor. Now where can we start? And the people who were washing the thing there were peasants, most of them. And the two teachers and one secretary at a rural district council in town. So we said, okay, we are here, but we know that the God of Ezekiel is here.
Amen.
We are not alone. The God of Ezekiel is here. So we started teaching those people about giving. And since we were going to do a lot of work there, you were someone who was going to lead by example. And we didn't leave what we were, the trade which we had been told before, that you should give. Because the Bible says, give, and it shall be given back unto you.
Amen.
A good measure, shaken together, and running over shall men give unto your bosom. So this verse here, Hebrews 6 verse 12, it strengthens me very, very much.
Amen.
Who through faith and patience inherit the promises. Amen.
Amen.
So we started teaching them to give, and would give, and would give. And God did something which I don't know why he wanted to do that. Instead of blessing us, we were still in that pot which God wanted us to be refined. He blessed the teachers, the secretary, and other saints, because when we got there, the teachers didn't even have sofas. Some of them were sleeping on the floor, but then God started blessing them because they were now giving. And they had beds, they had sofas, they had fridges, they had stoves, they had everything. And we still had that sofa, and we still had that TV, but we were teaching them to give. And we would see their lives blossoming in the Lord. But God gave us a heart I don't understand even up to now, because we never envied them, or we never said, why is God doing that? We just rejoiced with them as they prospered and praised the God of Ezekiel.
Amen.
Now, the farm which we were subdividing, the papers that had gone through, and my husband now got a job with an insurance company. And as he did that, God promoted him now to a better position in the company. And he was given a carbon car, and he was given some other pets, which we really enjoyed that the boat was now moving. But then in the midst of that, he just decided that, ah, no, I no longer want to work for this company. I want to do my own things. Then I said, Baba, how can you do this? Look, we are now working, and I'm also working. I think things will move as we are doing this. Then he said, no, I don't want. Then he was given his pets, and then bought a combi. He first of all bought a twin cab, and then he was using two pilots to do ferry people from one place to the next using that twin cab. And after the twin cab, he decided to sell it and bought a T-35, a bigger truck. It was breaking down time and again. And there was not enough money to go with it to the garages for it to be repaired. He would repair it on his own. But God was preparing for something better.
Amen.
We didn't know what was God doing, but he just enabled it to just break down. And he would take that company and panel beat it on his own, paint it on his own, then on the road. As it goes on the road, 2 days it breaks down. He's fixing the engine and whatnot. It's now drawing even the money which I was working as a public servant. What can we do? But we continued giving the Lord. We never said we don't yet. Because at times when you are a leader and you are asked to give, you say, I don't yet. Because people don't know what I'm experiencing at my home thing. We never told anyone what was happening, but people see. They just see that these people are in trouble. Amen.
Amen.
But God is very faithful. I like the God of Ezekiel because he doesn't leave us.
Amen.
He is the true God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob.
Amen.
Then one day, as he was fixing his vehicle along the road, someone phoned and said, oh, Mr. Torai, I heard that you have self-divided your farm. We want to buy a portion. And we are coming this weekend. We are coming this weekend to pay up some of the money. We want the biggest portion, 53 hectares, because the farm is very, very big. And this other portion for 57 hectares is one for Charles. So he said he wanted this one. Then he said, oh, you can come. And then he came. Surely he paid, the debt was 1.8 million by that time. And 1.8 million by that time in Zimbabwe, it was something unheard of. People would just say, you are mad, you people. How can you owe this much? Where do you think you can ever get the money to repay this? But he came, this person, with the money which was over 500,000. And he paid us. We were making talents. And it was the last year, the last day for closing talents. He sort of brought the money on a Friday. And the weekend we were going to celebrate Talents Day. God is so faithful. Now, when he came with this money, since we knew our God, we took some of the money. It was quite a substantial amount of money, and we gave it to the talents.
Amen.
Instead of people rejoicing with us that you have brought money for talents, people said, now you were hiding money at your home. You now know that the talents are closing today. You want to be number one and just you bring the money at the end of the talent's day. How can you do this? Now, Lord, what can we do? But we are doing it for the Lord. And also, you know where we got the money and how we got the money and when we got the money. We gave the money anyway. But it made people, don't know. Just don't know. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Now, when this person had brought in the money, again with quite some money, and he paid us. Another one phoned again from Harare. There were three people. He gave us some money, and it made us pay that debt, 1.8 million. God is so faithful.
Amen.
Since we now didn't have a car, we were praying with the children, God, can you give us a car? We wanted twin cab, so that if we are there with the family, it is enough for us. So another person phoned from Harare. I'm coming, I want to buy land. And he came and said, but I don't have money, I have a twin cab. I want you to exchange the land with my twin cab, and then the difference I'll pay later. Then he said, praise the Lord, because that's what we have been praying. We took the car, and then we were done. Now, when we had this car, it didn't have the canopy. My husband said, I'm now going to get a canopy so that we will be driving with the children. Our goods will be in the loading box, and then water or rain will not affect anything. So he went to this garage, which is Manikal and Coach Builders, because entirely they know it. And it was run by whites, a lady and his husband. And as he was just approaching, they said, oh, you are the one whom we have been waiting for. We want you to take over this garage. We want you to be the owner of this garage. Then my husband said, but I don't have money. Then they said, oh no, don't worry. We'll tell you how you can pay it up. You just come here, and then you wait for us for quite some bit of time. As people will be coming with their cars to be repaired, you pay us some of the money, and some of the money you take it for your family until the garage is paid off. Then he asked, how much is it? They said, 15 million. Now imagine when he came to me and said, I am now embarking on a 15 million project. I said, Baba, are you sure you can go again into a debt of 15 million? And yet we have struggled all these years to pay 1.8 million. How could you ever do that? But people of God, God is very faithful.
Amen.
For those with husbands, I urge you, at times it's better to listen to them, because they are the visionary of the home. Amen. God is so faithful. Hallelujah. So he came and told me, and I just say in the end, okay, I'll join you, let's do that. Then I resigned my job, and we started doing this company. God just did a miracle. Within 1 year, we had paid off the 15 million. And it was now our garage. And the wives had moved away. And we were now with these people, and everything was ours. It is a very big garage, one of the biggest in Mutare. So, as we were still working on that, another white man came and said, I heard that you took Manikal and Coach Builders. You know, the economy of this country can't sustain me. I want to close my engineering company, and I'm looking for someone to buy the equipment and the people. Can you do it for me? And then we took it off. Then another one came, bought gas glass company. They said, we are closing, the economy can't sustain us. Can you take the equipment and the people? Then we said, we can't take the people, but we can take the equipment. We took off. Then another one came. He said, the upholstering company, Bimora and Sons. They said, the economy can't sustain us. Can you take the equipment? Because we want to sell everything. Then we took it. Restaurants. People were finding it difficult for them to run them. We took two restaurants. Then another company for transport, we took it off again. There were now six companies all in all, and the farm the seventh.
Amen.
We were still selling the clothes. God is very faithful.
Amen. Amen.
God. Amen. When we say do not be deceived, God is
Amen.
Not mocked.
Amen.
For whatever you are going to sow,
Amen.
You are going to reap.
Amen.
If you don't lose heart.
Amen.
Because our God is a faithful
Amen.
God.
Amen.
Hebrews 6 verse 12, it says, who through faith and patience inherit the promises. In this year of revelation, of knowing our inheritance in God,
Amen.
We should be patient and have faith that one day God is going to do it.
Amen.
The way He did for it for us is not the way He's going to do it for you.
Amen.
God's ways are not our ways,
Amen.
And His thoughts are not our thoughts.
Amen.
As far as the heavens is above the earth, so high are His ways and thoughts above
Amen.
Ours. One day in due season you are going to reap. If you don't lose heart, it only needs patience. It only needs maturity. In this year of revelation of seeking our inheritance, you need to be mature in the Lord and say, God, without giving you, I will not have anything. Without giving you, I will not be rich. As our Father rightly says that to be rich is to have everything. For your family, for yourself, and then the rest you are going to give to the church and other people as well.
Amen.
So we should aspire that it's the blessing of the Lord which maketh rich.
Amen.
And He addeth no sorrow with it.
Amen.
People of God, if we don't lose that, in this year of inheritance, God is faithful and just.
He
is going to do something.
He
is going to do something. And just like Paul, I have not appreciated it yet, but I just forget what is behind and look forward, for there is the prize I am waiting for. There is a goal to be met, and that prize to be met, that's what I'm still aspiring, people of God. God bless you.